Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So this is the final section of this chapter, chapter 25, of the third canto, on the topic of Sankhya Yoga.
就是这个最后的第章节的最后一个部分 在第三篇第25章里面讲到这个 Sankhya Yoga的这个内容。
Devahuti is inquiring from Lord Kapilade.
Devahuti呢向主Kapila来询问。
And Lord Kapila is instructing his mother in how to perform Bhakti Yoga.
主Kapila就在训示他的母亲要怎么样来进行动爱瑜伽。
Lord Kapila, of course, gave great importance to the association of devotees and hearing the topics of the Lord.
那主Kapila当然是跟这个强调跟奉献者的联谊还有聆听关于主的这一些主题是非常重要的。
So Mother Devahuti wants to know more. She is explained here. She wants to know about Bhakti Yoga in more depth, because Lord Kapila is only given the essence. He's only given the very essence of it.
那德巴穆提他想要更深入的去了解，因为呢，这个主卡皮拉只是跟他讲这个精髓。
So, Lord Kapila is going to explain in more detail.
那主卡皮拉就要解释的更细节。
First of all, Devahuti inquires.
首先，Devahuti就询问了。
What kind of devotional service is worth developing and practicing to help me easily and immediately attain the service of your lotus feet?
所以，Devahuti就问了，什么样的奉献服务值得发展，还有进行，而且使我能够轻易的。
So Devahuti, she's saying she wants help. It should be immediate and also easy.
So Devahuti 想要就是说有马上的有结果，而且是容易的。
Sometimes devotees would ask Prabhupada like that. Prabhupada, I want to get Krishna prema immediately.
有时候呢，奉献者也问Prabhupada说，我想很快的得到对 Krishna 的爱。
Go on the fast track.
我要走快车道。
So here you see Devahuti also. Of course, her motivation is for the service of the lotus feet of the Lord.
当然，在这里，Devahuti的目的是想要可以快速的去服务主的莲花主。
Service begins with contemplating the Lord's lotus feet.
服务是从冥想。 主的莲花主开始。
So Devahuti's inquiry is very nice.
所以 Devahuti的询问是非常好的。
She wants to know, because Lord Kapila was saying nine different kinds of devotional service, so which one is worth developing and practicing?
因为主Kapila讲到这个九项奉爱服务，那所以 Devahuti就问说哪一个比较重要，可以发展。
Some are more difficult than others. So here's this is from Prabhupada's purport. So it doesn't matter what is one's material situation.
And
Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Yehi partha vai pashritya tepi su papa yonaya striyo vaishas tata sudras tepi yanti paramgati. Then even one may be of lower birth, like a vaishya, or a woman, or a sudra, But still, if they're engaged in devotional service, they can attain the supreme destination.
所以即使一个人呢，不管他是一个 Vaishya 或是一个女士，一个女人劳动啊，生意人呐，只要她被主进行奉爱服务的话，她就可以被提升到最高的这个完美的阶段，而可以回到这个灵性王国。
So the material situation, the material body is not a qualification or a disqualification.
所以物质的身体哈，或者是物质的这个状态呢，不是一个人的，所以会被决定这些的资格。
Lord Chaitanya used to quote the Srimad Bhagavatam where it says, stay in whatever position you are in.
就他呀就引述《佛伽瓦坛》里面说就是 处在你所处的处境里面
and just simply hear about Krishna in the association.
那仅仅就是说 去聆听 Krishna的这一些讯息 那就是在联谊之中去获得
So Devahuti inquires about the she also inquires about the various mystic yoga system.
那德瓦穆提也询问了很多不同的瑜伽系统。
And you'll find in other chapters of this Kapila, in the next chapter, Lord Kapila goes into Jnana Yoga and then Astanga Yoga.
接着其他的章节呢，就卡皮达会讲到这个思想瑜伽啦、体位瑜伽这些部分。
Remember, Lord Kapila was speaking in the Satya Yuga, so people were living a very long life, and it was common for people to engage in mystic yoga.
在 Satya 年代的时候，那人们的寿命非常长，所以人们呢也非常的习惯去做这些瑜伽的冥想。
But Lord Kapila points out, and Srila Prabhupada also enforces it in his purports that devotional service is the safest process.
当然呢，就卡皮亚也说，包括他也强调，奉爱服务是最安全的程序。
If you do these other yoga processes, there's always a chance of falling back, coming back to the material world. If we're not engaged in devotional service, then we can always have to come back to the material world.
如果我们没有去进行奉爱服务的话，我们就必会回到物质世界。
So in the Bhagavatam they talk about this Bhagavad Banna, meaning the arrow of the Supreme Lord. The arrow has to be, you have to aim the arrow towards the target, and the target is the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
那这个箭就有要射的为标的啊目的，那就是要是对着自，我们要射向至尊主。
You don't want impersonal liberation. You don't want to go to the Brahmajyoti. You don't want Paramatma. You don't want just simply to know the Paramatma. You want to know the Supreme Personality of God.
啊，我们不想要到梵的阶段，不想要解脱，也不想说到这个超灵这些。我们只是要到至尊主，不想到。
We don't want anything other but Krishna.
我们都不要其他。 只要 Krishna,
Paramatma and Brahmana, they're not for the devotees.
超灵啊，梵啊，这些阶段呢，奉献者是不想要。
So take aim, watch this arrow, take aim, and there we go, boom!
注意那个箭头一直射到那个 Krishna 那个灵性世界。
You got to aim at Krishna, you got to aim at Krishna, nothing else.
就是目的是要到Krishna那儿，然后没有其他的目的。Do
these other yogas, you can get distracted and forget the goal.
做其他的瑜伽，你会被分心，然后到其他的地方了。So
Devahuti is saying to Lord Kapila, she's appealing to Lord Kapila. She said, I'm a woman, it's not easy for me to understand the absolute truth.
所以Devahuti对Kapila说呢， 哇，我是一个女人，要了解这些东西的，我是不容易去了解。I'm
not very intelligent.
我并不聪明。
But if you will explain it to me, then I can understand.
但是如果你向我解释，我可以了解的。
Remember in the first class we were talking, Lord Kapila was saying to his mother, Devahuti was saying to Lord Kapila, you are my transcendental I.
记得第一个部分的时候，我们讲到这个Devahuti说的，他跟Kapila说，你是我超然的眼睛。
By the mercy of the spiritual master, we can see the truth, we can understand the absolute truth.
由于灵性导师的仁慈，我们可以看到真理，然后看到这绝对真理。
We are singing every morning in the Guru Vastika by Yashya Prasada Bhagavad Prasado, Yashya Prasada Nagati Kato. By the mercy of the spiritual master, you get the mercy of Krishna.
所以在每天早上呢，我们在念唱着灵师八颂的祷文的时候，就是说，由于灵性导师的仁慈，我们得到 Krishna.
Without the mercy of the spiritual master, then we cannot understand.
没有灵性导师的仁慈，我们就无法去了解真理。所以，Devahuti是请求的主卡皮拉。Your
mercy。就是我需要你的仁慈。Like that, we all need to get the mercy of the spiritual
teacher。所以我们都需要得到灵性老师的仁慈。Just
like we're saying here. By the mercy of the spiritual master, then everything is revealed. Even the disciple may be not, he may be unintelligent, may not have a very high IQ, may not be very intelligent. But if they are obedient and faithful to the orders of the spiritual master,
那如果是说对灵性导师有信心，而且是这样子的乖巧顺从的话，那这个真理会从灵性导师那边给我们揭示。Therefore,
you can see in the morning program how we begin the Mangal Arti. We sing Guru Vastikam, eight prayers to the spiritual master.
因此呢，我们可以看到这个每日的早课的时候，就是说，对灵性导师怎么样的祈祷，这个灵师八颂这样子的内容，是的。And
then we do the Guru Puja for Srila Prabhupada, and we sing Guru Vandana.
接着我们对Prabhupada做这个 Puja 崇拜，就是念诵这个灵师颂歌。So
both these songs, the Guru Vastika and the Guru Vandana, they are prayers, they are an appeal to the spiritual master to give blessing, to bless us, to be kind to us.
所以这个灵师八颂还有灵师颂歌呢，都是这些祷文来让我们可以就是说恰当的对灵性导师做祈祷。We
need to get that blessing to understand the truth.
然后我们需要这样子的祈祷而得到这个祝福，来了解真理。
Somebody may be very materially intelligent, they may have a high IQ, they've studied a lot.
有一些人可能智商很高啦，很聪明啦，学了很多。
They've taken all many degrees, and they've done their PhD, they've got their doctorate.
他们呢，就是说，拿了很多学位啦，博士学位啦，等等。
But if they're not devotees, if they have not got the mercy of the spiritual master, then they won't be able to understand the scripture.
但是如果他们没有得到灵性导师的仁慈的话，他们就没办法了解这经典。They
have to have faith in both Krishna and the spiritual teacher.
所以我们必须对 Krishna 还有灵性的老师们有信心。
So hearing these words of Devahuti, Lord Kapiladev's heart is melted.
那这里说到呢，主卡皮拉受到这Devahuti的这样的亲近，而觉得感动。Remember
who is Devahuti? She's a daughter of Swayambhuva Manu.
记得谁是Devahuti吗？她是Swayambhuva Manu的女儿。So
she came from a very noble, very royal family. Her father was also a great devotee.
所以她是从一个非常高贵的皇室家族，那她的父亲也是一个伟大的奉献者。
But she was so humble. She was saying, "No, I'm unintelligent. I'm a woman. I don't know anything. Please tell me."
她是那么的谦卑，说我只是一个女人呐，啊，我一点也不聪明啊，我是没有那么聪明，没有智慧。
So hearing this humble appeal of Devahuti, Lord Kapila is going to explain more about Sankhya.
Kapila听到这个Devahuti这样的谦逊的祈求跟询问呢，对吧？那个主Kapila就更想要来对他做更多的解释。
And Lord Kapila explains about the relationship between the senses and the mind.
所以主Kapila接着就来解释说。
And he compares the senses to the demigods and the mind to the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
他就比喻呢，就说感官呢，就像比喻成半神人，那这个心意呢，就是至尊主这样子的。
The demigods are all servants of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
这些半神人们呢，是至尊守神的仆人。
In the same way, the senses are meant to serve the mind. The senses are meant to work under the direction of the mind.
那同样，这个感官是跟随心意的方向去服务。The
mind is the king of the senses.
心意是感官之王。And
the mind's duty is to serve.
那心意的责任呢？
And that service is meant to be done for the Supreme Lord.
那个服务是为了至尊主而做的。
But it's meant to be done without any motive.
但是这个服务要是完全没有任何其他动机的做。
You simply want to serve the Lord out of pure devotion.
完全只是纯粹的奉爱，这样要去服务主。
You can see these nice devotees engaging their mind and senses in Krishna consciousness. So come to our temples and this is the activities which go on there.
那这就是他们来到庙里面，这是他们进行的活动。
But we engage our mind and senses in the service of Krishna, we feel happiness.
那如果我们的心意跟感官来为 Krishna 做服务，我们会感到快乐。
We're not giving people any material, any great material benefits from here.
啊，我们不是说要给人们任何物质上的益处。
But there's spiritual benefits, spiritual pleasure.
是有灵性的益处跟灵性的快乐。
So that happiness of devotional service is great, far greater than whole ocean of material pleasure. Even the happiness of becoming one with the Supreme, it is only a tiny fraction of the happiness from devotional service.
即使说跟至尊主合而为一的这个快乐，也只是比不上那在奉爱服务得到的快乐那么。
And that's why so many people, that's why these devotees, that's why these young devotees are coming to the temple. They're experiencing transcendental pleasure. So Lord Kapila goes on now to describe the nature, the effect of bhakti yoga, what it does. It dissolves the subtle body.
那Kapila又继续说了，奉爱瑜伽的情况是怎么样？就是在奉爱的服务里面，会把金贵的身体融化。
Subtle body means our mind, our intelligence, and false ego is all dissolved by bhakti yoga.
金贵的身体就是说，啊，这些啦，心意啦，智慧啦，假我啦，都会在奉爱服务的过程中把它融化。
And Lord Kapila gives an example to help us understand. So just like fire in the stomach digests everything that we eat.
就是卡皮拉就是用这个例子说了，解释，就像我们的胃火 会把所有的食物消化了。
So the same with Bhakti Yoga dissolves sattva-guna.
同样这个啊，风爱瑜伽就会把我们这些精微的身体部分呢，也把它融掉。
We don't have to do anything. We just have to engage in Bhakti Yoga, and it happens automatically.
我们不用做任何事情，只要去进行风爱瑜伽，那这些状况会自然的同时发生。
Just like when we eat food, a healthy person, when we eat, you digest the food.
就是说。就像我们健康的人吃了食物呢，他这个身体会这个胃会自动去消化。当然啦，中午要吃，不是说晚上吃。
Then the power of digestion is more.
因为在中午那个时候，胃火消化力比较足。
At night, power of digestion is very low.
在晚上这个消化力啊就变得很弱。
We had one Chinese doctor came to Malaysia for the convention. There was a convention in Malaysia. One Chinese doctor came who was treating Jayapataka Swami.
有一个中国的医生呢，去到马来西亚，就说奉献者的这个大的联谊聚会呢，然后这个人就是帮 Jayapataka Maharaj 来治疗。
So this doctor is a Chinese traditional doctor, and he's been very successful in treating people, and he's hoping that he can cure Jayapataka Swami also.
那这个人呢，他是一个中医，而且就说治了很多人，所以这个时候也希望说可以帮 Jayapataka Maharaj 来治疗。
And so he gave a talk to all the devotees, and he said, if you want to get cured from any of your problems, your health problem, don't eat after 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
这个中医呢就跟大家说呢，如果你们要有任何疾病呢，就是下午两点之后就不要吃东西了。
Because after 2 o'clock in the afternoon, then the power of digestion is gone. You can't digest food. This is why all your health problems come.
他说呢，下午两点之后吃东西呢，因为这个胃火已经没有了，所以身体就会出毛病。
Quite a challenge to the
devotee.
But I remember when I became a devotee, I was told Prabhupada had given the instruction, devotees should not eat any grains after 4 o'clock in the afternoon.
当我最开始进入成为奉献者的时候，我曾经听说过Prabhupada说过奉献者在下午四点以后不要吃谷类食物。
Because grains are hard to digest.
因为谷类食物比较难消化的。
So Prabhupada told, he wanted to do this like that. He said, you can take a little milk and maybe some pieces of fruit if you need it, and then take rest. And then you can get up early in the morning.
所以呢奉献者就是如果下午之后不吃那些补的话，那就可能喝一些牛奶啦，或者吃水果啦，吃清淡的，然后去睡觉，早上就比较容易早起。
See, we changed the picture. Here's the big feast coming.
所以我们换了图片了，你看这里面食物。
Here's the Raj Bhog offering.
这是这个Raj Bhoga 就是对主的。
Right, the Raj Bhog means offering at midday.
这个是指中午的这个食物的供奉。Raj Bhoga.
We don't offer a Raj Bhog at night.
晚上就不是供奉这个 Raj Bhoga。
In the night, we offer some, even for Krishna, some fried, some puri, some snack.
那晚上就给 Krishna 供奉的，也就是没有那么所谓全餐哈，就是那么不好消化的，就是一些清淡的啊，炸一点东西啊，这样子。
Okay, so that Lord Kapila is making the point that bhakti, the path of devotion, is much better.Than the path of liberation.
那这卡皮亚就说，奉爱的途径是比这个非人格的练习的解脱是好得多了。
Devotional service. For one who is engaged in bhakti yoga, liberation is not important.
对
People want to get liberation, and Mayavadis, impersonalists, they work very hard to get liberation, but it's an insecure platform. They could easily fall down from that platform.
那些非人格啊，假象中的人啊，就是说很辛苦的想要达到解脱，但是呢，那种他们达到解脱的情况也是非常不安全，没有保证。Devotional
service begins on the liberating platform.
因为奉爱服务开始的阶段是在解脱了开始。And
for one who is a devotee, liberation is there at any time.
对一个奉献者来讲，他任何时刻都是在解脱的。And
he said that he has written a poem in his book Krishna Karanamrita, saying that when I am engaged in devotional service, I see liberation standing with arms folded, waiting to serve.
有一个奉献的Bibamongala Thakur在他的 Krishna Katamrita 这书里面写的，他说当我在进行奉爱服务的时候，我看到解脱是站在门口拱着手，这样子顶着等。So
devotional service is not for just simply getting liberation.
所以奉爱服务不是只是想要得到解脱。Devotee is
so happy with devotional service, he doesn't want any.
奉献者是非常快乐的在想进行奉爱服务，他不想要其他东西。This
life is described here, but that one who is engaged in Krishna's service, he never wants to become one. He doesn't want that kind of liberation, becoming one with him.
所以对于在这边解释呢，对于奉献者来讲。
Becoming one with the Lord, that is called Sayuja Mukti. There are five different kinds of liberation. So becoming one with the Lord, that is never accepted by a devotee.
跟主合而为一的话呢，永远不会被奉献者接受的。Because
in that condition, there's no opportunity for devotional service.
因为在那样的状况下，就没有机会来为主做服务了。So
a devotee doesn't want to be put into that kind of condition where there's no devotional service.
所以奉献者不想被放到那样的状态，就是没有奉爱服务的状态。
That is hell for a devotee. Devotee doesn't care what condition is put into materially. He can go anywhere in any condition. Even let me become an insect in the home of a devotee.
让我投身在奉献者家里的，成为他家里的一只蚂蚁。
Just think about the insects in your home.
想想家里那些小虫子。
Maybe they're great devotees and they come to take association.
也许他们是伟大的奉献者，要来跟你联谊。
So we have to think how to give them Krishna consciousness.
我们要想要怎么样给他们Krishna知觉。
Devotee can be in any condition of life.
奉献者是可以处在任何的处境状态里。
But he wants to have the opportunity to hear about the pastimes of the Lord and to glorify the Lord.
因为他想要在任何处境都是有机会可以听到、聆听啊，这主的这些逍遥时光等等。
So, you get education, real education. To fix the mind on Krishna's lotus feet.
所以呢，真正的教育呢，是就是说把心意呢放在主的莲花主，Krishna的莲花主。We
have to always remember Krishna.
我们必须是一直总是记得Krishna。
So how we remember Krishna by thinking of his form?
我们怎么
And when we think of Krishna's form, we should begin from his lotus feet.
当我们在冥想着 Krishna 的形体的时候，我们必须要先从他的脚莲花足开始。
Just like when you go to meet a superior person, we bow our head before them, then we look up gradually.
就像我们去看一些长者啦、高位的人啦，我们是先想要跟他拱着顶拜，就是先从他的脚这样看，然后往上看。
In the same way, when we go to see the deity, we look at the lotus feet of the deity, then look up to the face of the Lord.
同样的呢，当我们去见神像的时候，也是先从他的脚这样，然后再往上这样子看到他的脸。
But the first thing is to fix our mind on the feet of the Lord.
而第一件事就是将我们的心意专注在主的莲花足。
You can think of the different markings on the lotus feet of the Lord.
可以去想着主的莲花足的各种标记。
You can think how Krishna's feet pierced the covering in the universe and brought in the water of the Ganga.
可以去想着主的莲花足，就像莲花足怎么样把这个宇宙的那一层击破，然后让恒河流出来。
Think of the beauty of Lord Krishna's lotus feet.
可以去想着Krishna莲花足的美。
Talking more about the happiness of becoming, the happiness of becoming one with the Supreme, is considered hellish for a devotee.
提到呢，这个跟至尊组合而为一的那个所谓的快乐，对奉献者来讲是一种地狱状态。
The devotee doesn't want that kind of liberation.
奉献者不想要那一种解脱。
Giving up our individuality, merging with the oneness of Brahman.
放弃我们的独立性，然后融到这个饭里面。
It's hellish because there's no activity, there's no opportunity for engagement in the service of Krishna.
那样像地狱一样，因为没有机会。 没有机会，没有那个情况可以为主做服务。
Instead, you can see here, Prabhupada.
我们可以看着他这样子。
What a devotee is always busy thinking how to serve Krishna.
就是奉献者总是在忙着去想着要怎么样来服务 Krishna.
Even though there may be so many obstacles.
即使说有很多的这个障碍。
Just like Prabhupada. When he was a young man, he had a family, he had children to support.
就好像巴布巴在比较年轻的时候，他有家庭责任，还有这个小孩要去养照顾。
So many obstacles were there.
当时也是很多的这种障碍。
But still, he was always thinking about how to serve Krishna.
虽然这样，他还是一直在想着要怎么样来服务 Krishna.
He said he never forgot Krishna throughout his life.
他说他从来一生中没有去忘记 Krishna.
And we see also Bhaktivinoda Thakur also the same thing.
我们看到Bhaktivinoda Thakur也是一样的。
He was a working man. He was in the court. He was a judge. He was doing so many different duties.
当时他也是在工作，然后也是法官，然后还有很多的这些责任啊，工作要去做。
But he wrote so many books and so many poems to glorify Krishna. So that's the devotee. Always thinking how to serve Lord Chaitanya. How to encourage the Sankirtan movement.
就是想着怎么样来鼓舞这 极受圣名的运动。
How to give people, how to awaken people to Krishna consciousness.
怎么样去唤醒人们的 Krishna 知觉。
You see Prabhupada appreciating, relishing the paintings done by the devotees.
那看着这样子，包括在那边欣赏着奉献者所做的结果。
All of these paintings which are in the Srimad Bhagavatam in the different volumes Srimad Bhagavatam, they were all authorized by Prabhupada. Prabhupada would tell them exactly how to paint the different people.
那所有在这个《博伽瓦坛》里面的这一些图画，都是 Prabhupada 认可的 Prabhupada 告诉那些画这些图片的这些奉献者应该是要怎么样的情况。
You can see on the original Bhagavatam, Prabhupada painted the cover of the Bhagavatam, which is a picture of the universe with the spiritual world, Goloka Vrindavan, Vaikuntha planets, and then the material world.
就我们看到《波切瓦坛》的封面的第一本的那个封面，就是说整个这个宇宙啊，包括这个灵性世界，还有很多的Vaikuntha星球这些。
So Prabhupada painted that picture himself.
那一幅是 Prabhupada 自己画的。
And then later on, when he got more artists joining him, he engaged them to paint all of his pictures.
那之后呢？啊，有更多的奉献者是这些艺术家、画家，然后他就让他们来继续做啊其他的这个书本里面的画。
Because, we have to be able to remember Krishna.
所以我们必须要有办法让自己去记得 Krishna.
So to help us remember Krishna, Krishna comes in his Archavigraha, the form of the deity.
那去记得 Krishna, 那 Krishna 也是自己以神像的形体出现。
The deity is from the transformation of material elements into spiritual energy.
所以就是说从这个怎么样是物质的元素转成到灵性的元素。
We need to be able to see Krishna.
我们必须要能够去见到 Krishna。
But we don't have perfect senses. We're not able to see Krishna.
然后我们的感官是不完美的，我们是没办法去看到 Krishna。
So therefore, Krishna comes in the form of the deity.
因此 ，Krishna 是以神像的形态出现。
In the form of the deity, we have an opportunity to see the form of the Lord.
那在主有神像的形体出现，让我们有机会去见到主。
And we can know Krishna more as a person.
那我们可以就是更容易去了解 Krishna 也是一个人。
So it's very important for the devotee practicing Bhakti Yoga. It's important that we engage in deity worship.
因此呢，对于奉献者、从事奉爱瑜伽的人去做神像崇拜也是很重要的。
Take up the mood of being a servant.
所以必须要是用是 Krishna 的仆人的心态去做。
So Krishna appears in many different forms.
Krishna 是有不同的形体这样出现。
Some people are worshipping the Lord in the form of Krishna. Some is Rama. More, of course, are worshipping Gornikai.
有一些人啊，有些奉献崇拜 Krishna， 有些人崇拜 Ram， 那更多人崇拜这 Gornikai。
We hear also we have Jagannath Baladev Subhadra.
我们这儿也有 Jagannath Baladev Subhadra.
So we have to see the deity as a transcendental person.
所以我们必须是要能够去把神像去看着是超然的人。
Bringing the deity here becomes a great commitment for all the devotees here.
所以啊，有神像的到来对奉献者来讲是一个很大的一种承诺。
Everyone has to feel some responsibility for the service of the deity.
每个人都要是觉得对服务神像有一些责任。
And having the deity here, we have an opportunity to cultivate our relationship with the deity.
那有神像的存在，就是让我们有机会培养跟神像的关系。
Lord Kapila talks about how when you come and see the deity, you can also talk with the deity.
那主卡比拉又说呢，当我们见到神像呢，也是能够跟神像说话。
It's important for all devotees to have this kind of personal relationship with the deity.
那这对所有的奉献者都是非常重要的，就是说跟神像有个人的关系。
Mayavadis, they don't worship deity.
假象中的人士，他们不崇拜神像。
But they have Krishna. They have a. They have. It looks like the same as us. They may have the statue of Krishna there in their temple.
他们呢？看 看起来是有神像啊，就是在他们庙也是有Krishna的这个雕像。
But they're not thinking Krishna as a person.
但是他们不是把Krishna想成一个人，是个人。
They're thinking this is just a form of the Brahman, and this is just a means to help us to enter into the oneness.
他们只是想说这只是梵的形态。
So they don't worship deities. They just do what we call, what we would call, murti puja.
所以他们不崇拜神像，他们做只是叫做 murti puja，就好像我们说只是一种偶像而已。
They won't make regular offerings.
他们不会去做所谓规律的供奉。
They don't dress the deities.
也没帮神像这个穿衣服。
They don't decorate the deities. They don't take pleasure in looking at the beauty of the deity.
他们也没有去装扮神像啦，也没有去看说神像的美呀这些。
They don't talk to the deities.
他们没有跟神像说话。
But we do. We're supposed to be doing all that.
但是我们是这么做，而且我们也应该是要这样做。
I remember when I was in New, when I first offered arti in London to the deities there.
我记得我以前最开始第一次在伦敦在做对神像崇拜的时候。
Yeah, we have Radha, London Ishwara.
我们那边的神像是 Radha London Ishwara.
They were the very first Radha Krishna deities installed in the movement.
Now, in which place?
In London.
在伦敦啊，他们是很久以前就是最开始的第一对被开光的神像。
The first deities in the world of ISKCON.
是世界 ISKCON 的在全世界里面第一对是被开光的神像。Yeah,
and so when I was offered, when I after doing the arti, then the devotee told me, he said, now you have to tell Krishna.
当我在对神像做服务的时候，后来奉献者又跟我说：“现在你要跟 Krishna 说 ，Krishna， 你现在要休息了。”They
told me to fold your hands and you pray very respectfully. You have to say, "My dear Lordship, Sri Sri Radha Mandanishwar, it is now time to take rest."
然后奉献者就跟我说：“你要手拱着手，然后对这个神像说。” 我亲爱的主啊，圣这个 Radha London Ishwara， 现在是你休息睡觉的时候了。那我们就请这个主啊，准备睡觉了。
And of course, when we offer food, that when we offer food, we offer prayers. We also recite prayers. We don't just ring the bell, but we offer prayers. We're telling Krishna these prayers are Krishna's invitation to come and eat.
当然啦，我们在供奉食物也是要献上祷文，要讲特别的祷文，然后请主邀请主现在过来吃东西。Yeah,
Krishna can eat. We're not just offer. It's not just some ritual. Krishna actually eats the food if we offer with love and devotion.
所以那不是一种所谓的仪式而已，是 Krishna 真的看着或是怎么样 ，Krishna 是真正，如果我们用奉爱的心态去供奉的话 ，Krishna 是真正会去吃的。
Has he eaten any of the offerings? Have you seen any of the offerings being eaten here?
你有没有见过所有？那你们有没有任何人见过任何供奉被吃完被 Krishna 吃掉了？
No.
没有。
Well, we haven't had enough devotion.
就是我们奉爱不够。
But the deity is a person. He can eat. He can speak. He can hear.
神像是这样子真实的人，他可以听到，他可以看到，他也可以去吃。
He can see also. He sees everything we're doing.
而且他是可以。 看到的，他看到我们所做的任何一切。
So it's very big responsibility to worship the deity.
所以去崇拜神像是非常大的责任。
That's why usually the deity worship is done by twice initiated.
所以一般。
Of course, somebody is preparing for initiation.
那当然呢，有一些人是想要准备去做，得到启迪。
But we have to understand the deity is not just a statue.
但我们必须要了解，神像不是只是那种像偶像或塑雕塑。
I can see, the deity sees, the deity hears everything.
神像是听得到、看得到，他听到我们所说的一切，看到我们所做的一切。
Just like it's an offense to argue in front of the deity.
所以同样在神像面前去讨争论吵架是冒犯的。
In the temple in front of the deity, we have to behave very respectfully.
所以在庙里面神像面前是必须非常这样恭敬的态度，很尊敬的。
Because the deity is here, the Lord is here, and he's deity.
因为神像在这儿，主在这儿。
This is Radha Paris Ishvara.
那这是 Radha Paris Ishvara.
You can see Prabhupada offering arti there.
可以看到Prabhupada在那边呢做崇拜，神像的崇拜。
Prabhupada said French girls are very beautiful.
哈哈，Prabhupada说法国女孩非常的美。
So he said that Radharani with Paris Ishvara is very beautiful.
So Prabhupada said that this Paris Ishvara.
This is France, not Paris.
Yes,
it's
in France.
So we want to. You know, we all want to be looking at the deities. When we look at the deities, we should see if the deity is smiling or not.
所以呢，我们都想要见到这个神像的脸庞。那我们必须要是见到神像是带着笑脸的。
You can tell if the deity is pleased with us.
从神像的脸，我们可以知道神像对我们觉得感到高兴或。
You look at the deity, you can tell. Is the deity, are the deities, do they look happy? Are they smiling blissfully?
我们去看着神像，会知道神像是不是在带着笑容，他们是不是很喜乐。
The decorations of the body of the Lord, or how we decorate the deity, is always appreciated by the devotees.
所以去帮神像打扮啊，他身上的这些装扮啊。
这个主是非常欣赏、非常喜欢的。I remember one time, when I was in one temple in New York, it was one devotee. Every day after the deity darshan, after the morning program, he would come and say, "Do you remember what color of earrings did Krishna have on?"
我记得啊，我以前去过纽约的其中的一个庙，那每天的时候。 就是说，有个奉献者跟我说：“你记得昨天神像这个什么身体的颜色或衣服的颜色是什么吗？”
What color was his earrings?
啊，他昨天戴的耳环的颜色是什么？
What was his bracelet?
然后他的像他的手环又是什么样子？
Remembering all the different decoration in the day.
那就是说去记得神像所有各种各样的装扮。
You can see here how the deity is painted, the face is painted with the gopi gods.
那看这里呢，神像是怎么样的被点缀的啊？这些，沐浴姑娘一样的这个点点，这样。
In Mayapur also, in Radha Madhava, in Mayapur every morning, in Vrindavan, you see Radha Shamsunda, how they paint the decorate the faces of the deity.
像在 Mayapur, Radha Madhava, 在 Vrindavan, Radha Shamsunda, 他们是怎的？ 奉献者怎么样帮神像这个点缀他这些脸？This
is all the love, the expression of love of the devotees.
那这都是奉献者对主的爱的一种表达。We
want to be cultivating this kind of relationship with the deity.
我们想要去培养这一些跟神像的关系。The
deity it reciprocates with the devotee.
神像是跟奉献者交流的。
Just like we know in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, there's a story about how one devotee named Madhavendra Puri came to see the deity of Gopinath.
我们知道呢，在永恒的《切开牙经》里面呢，这个Madhavendra Puri 他跟这个神像 Gopinath 怎么样的在交流着。
This is at a place called Rimuna, which is in Orissa, near not far away, not very far from Jagannath Puri.
那个地方，那个当时是在 Rimuna 离Jagannath Puri 不远的地方。
It's a very famous deity. Even today, many people go there.
那个神像非常有名，即使到现在，很多人还是去那边朝拜。
And there's a they offer every day to the deity. They offer sweet rice.
他们每天供奉给神像是都有这个甜奶饭。
Yeah, they cook the milk and make it sweet.
煮这个牛奶啊，鲜奶。
So Madhavendra Puri was there hundreds of years ago. Before, even before the time of Lord Chaitanya.
Madhavendra Puri, 那个时候是几百年前，在主切开牙显现之前，他就常去那里。
And Madhavendra Puri was watching the offering, and he was thinking how nice it would be to taste the sweet rice because he wanted to offer to his deity.
那Madhavendra Puri 就看着这些庙里面的祭司怎么样在供奉这甜奶饭。 那他想尝一尝，然后他想知道这个味道，然后呢，对自己的神像同样的做这供奉。
But so that night, what happened was, the pujari had a dream, and in the dream, the deity told him to wake up and to come and get the pot of sweet rice.
那发生什么事呢？那天晚上呢，那个祭司在睡觉的时候，有一个梦，那神像。 出来跟他说，你起来，然后去拿一个锅子。
He said, "There's a cup of sweet rice. I saved a cup of sweet rice. I want you to give it to my devotee, Madhavendra Puri."
他说呢，那你去拿一个杯子，你装了一杯的甜奶饭，我要给我的奉献者，给这个 Madhavendra Puri.
So the pujari had never had a dream like that before.
那个祭司从来没有那一类的梦。
So he immediately woke up and went to the temple room.
所以他马上起床，然后去他那个神像房去看。
And in the temple room, he was amazed to see there was another cup of sweet rice there.
那他到了这个神像房里面去看，他很惊讶，还真的是有一杯的甜奶饭。
They offered many cups of sweet rice to the deity, but somehow he had left one on the altar.
因为他们呢。 供奉了很多杯的甜奶饭，但是不知怎么就是漏掉了，还留了一杯在那儿。What
had happened? The deity had stolen that cup of sweet rice.
这个情况是怎么样？是神像自己去把那一杯偷过来。So
that deity became known as Shirakora Gopinath. The deity who stole the sweet rice.
所以那神像变得很有名的 Shirakora Gopinath， 就是说偷着甜奶饭的神这个。
But the point is, the deity appeared in the dream of the pujari, because the pujari was a pure
devotee.
And the deity understood the mind of the other pure devotee.
那这个神像也知道他的另外一个纯洁的奉献者。
So when we get more pure devotees, you'll see the deities become more, they reciprocate more with the devotees.
所以当我们如果聚集更多的纯洁的奉献者的话，我们看到神像的光，就说这个面容会更加的这种喜悦，那种感觉。
We want to be becoming more absorbed in the service of the deity.
我们想要就是更加的专注进去对神像的服务。
Prabhupada taught us how to worship the deity.
他教导我们怎么样来崇拜神像。
The Prabhupada gave this lecture and he was saying, "Now make yourself ready to talk with Krishna."
所以他就说了，现在你准备好来跟 Krishna 对话。
then you can have a conversation with her.
之后呢, 你是有可能跟他对话交流的。
Sometimes Prabhupada would have conversations with Krishna.
有时候Prabhupada是直接跟Krishna有对话的。
Sometimes Krishna would come.
有时候Krishna是直接出现的。
Just like Prabhupada got told, you go to America, you go write your books.
就像Prabhupada, Krishna对他说呢, 你去美国,你要去写这书。
Prabhupada was not very eager to go.
那当时Prabhupada还不急着,不太想。
But Krishna was telling him, you have to go.
那Krishna跟他说,你必须要去。
So Krishna talks to his devotees.
所以Krishna是跟他的奉献者说话。
And we have to talk.
我们也必须要去说。
So, you know, sometimes people, of course, sometimes we talk very silly things.
有时候我们说很多蠢话。
We come to Krishna and we ask him, oh, I need a new car.
Krishna面临面说，Krishna，我需要一部新车。
Oh, Krishna, but no son, I need a son, you lose a son.
我家没有儿子啊，你帮我安排啊。
Oh, Krishna, I have this health problem, help me good health.
我有这个健康问题，请你给我这个健康。
Prabhupada tells a story, there was one lady, she was carrying a big basket of wood on her head, and she had to go through the forest. But one day she was coming through the forest with a big basket of wood, and she tripped, and all the wood fell down.
啊，Prabhupada说了一个故事，说有一个老女人，她就是我们说砍柴，有一天她经过森林里面，她不知道怎么踢到了。 头上顶的那一堆柴都掉上，掉在地上。
Oh, so she said, "Oh, what am I gonna do? Oh, I'll pray to God. Oh, God, please come, please help me."
他就想怎么办呢？神啊，神啊，请你出来吧，请你帮我啊。So,
Krishna came.
所以 Krishna 就真的来了。He
said, "Yes, what do you want?"
Krishna 说，是啊，你现在要什么啊？
And she said, "Can you help me get this wood on my head?"
Krishna 说，你可以帮我把这些柴。
放到我的头顶上吗？OK。那好啊，帮你放。OK，拜拜。再见啦，这样放好了。And Krishna
disappeared。那Krishna就消失了。Was
that very intelligent?
这真的很聪明吗？Krishna
comes and you ask her, "Help me get this wood on my head."
Krishna来了，那你只是叫他，请他把这个柴呀放到你头上。This
is what we do when we ask Krishna for some material things.
这就是我们在做的事，我们只是跟Krishna要一些这物质的东西。We
don't know what to ask Krishna for.
我们不知道跟Krishna要什么。What
should we ask for?
我们应该要去要什么？Devotional
service, birth after birth.
一世复一世的奉爱服务。Right,
devotee doesn't want impersonal liberation or mystic powers.
奉献者不想要这个。 非人格的解脱，或是任何神秘神通。Devotee
is not interested in all the wealth of heaven.
奉献者对于所有的天堂的财富也没兴趣。Devotee
just wants devotional service.
奉献者只想要一世又一世的奉爱服务。So,
the important for devotees to see the form of the deity.
所以对奉献者来讲，去见到神像的形态、形体是非常重要的。And
we should see the deity smiling and attractive.
而我们必须要见到神像是在带着笑容，而且很吸引人的。And
then when we hear his words, the pure devotee will lose all consciousness.
所以当我们听到神像的这些话语呢？ 纯粹奉献者就失去知觉了。Just
like when we come to the temple, we hear the words of Krishna, we hear the Bhagavad Gita.
就好像我们来到庙里，我们聆听 Krishna的话，像聆国节梵歌。Bhagavad
Gita are the words of Krishna.
国节梵歌是 Krishna的话语。
Srimad Bhagavatam are the words of his pure devotees.
圣典博切瓦坛是 Krishna的纯粹奉献者的话语。
So in this way we become fully absorbed in devotional service. And in this way, we get liberation without any effort on our part.
这样的情况，这样的方式，我们自然得到解脱，而没有说任何的努力，额外努力去做。
Lord Kapila says it, the devotee is not willing, he doesn't want it.
就卡比拉又说，奉献者根本不愿意，不想要了解。
Because the devotee is just so happy engaged in devotional service.
因为奉献者是那么快乐的在进行奉爱服务。
But sometimes Krishna gives it to the devotee.
但是有时候，Krishna会把这个给奉献者。
Here you can see this is the deity of Gopal. Gopal was discovered on Govardhan Hill.
这个是Gopal神像呢，在Govardhan山被发现了。
Madhavendra Puri had a dream, and the Krishna appeared in the dream and said, "Please come and take me out from this place. I want to be taken care of. I'm in this cold, wet place. You please get me out of here and take care and do worship."
那这个Gopal神像在 Madhavendra Puri 的梦里面出现，跟他说啊，你呀，你过来啊，你过来，把我带开这个地方，这边又冷又湿啊，你带回去啊，你照顾啊，给我东西吃。
So Madhavendra Puri, he got some people together and they went and they began to dig the ground for, according to where he was told in the dream. They went to this place on Govardhan Hill and they dug the ground and they brought out from below the ground, they brought out this deity of Lord Krishna.
So Madhavendra Puri just found some people, and according to the dream, the Gopal Shenxiang told him the place and the location, and went there to find, to dig, and found the Shenxiang.
And then Madhavendra Puri called all the people from the village. So were brought, and they made flower garlands for the deity.
那也有人带着这花啦，很多的花啦，还有花环啦，拿给神像这样子。
Everywhere there are flowers, you can gather some of the flowers, pick them and bring them and offer to the deity.
那处处都有花，他们就可以去收集那些花来给供奉给神像。
And then people were also engaged in cooking for the deity.
那也有，就是说，为神像做饭这些事。
And some Brahmins were also offering the arti for the deity.
那有一些婆罗门就对神像做这个arti。
And Madhavendra Puri then had another dream, and the deity told them, that I'm very hot now. I want you to bring me camphor and sandalwood.
那又有接着呢，这个神像又出现在 Madhavendra Puri 的梦里面，然后这个神像就说了，哎呀，我在这边很热很热，你呀去，帮我找这个明矾，还有这个檀香哈，檀香木。
So Madhavendra Puri had to from Vrindavan. He walked all the way to Jagannath Puri.
So this, Madhavendra Puri, just like this, from Vrindavan, Govardhan, this is a very far road, up to Jagannath Puri, the northern part, that is a
very far road. To bring sandalwood and camphor for the deity.
去找那个哈，那个樟脑跟这个檀香，要给神像用。
But before he went, he first of all, he made arrangements for the worship of the deity to go on.
在他去找这个檀香这些东西之前，他先安排其他人继续对神像的供奉这些。And
this deity is still being worshipped today.
而这神像一直到现在都还在被崇拜的。So
many hundreds of years.
已经数百年了。
You can go, we go there sometimes, it's in a place called Nath Dwara.
去他这个神像的那个庙的地方是Nathdwara。
It was originally found in Govardhan Hill, but it was taken to this town of Nathdwara to protect from the Muslims.
本来神像是被发现的地方是在Govardhan那儿，那后来为了躲这个穆斯林回教徒的攻击呢，所以把神像移到Nathdwara这边地方。
So Madhavendra Puri, when he got all the sandalwood and camphor, he was coming back, but then the deity appeared in his dream again and said, I want you to offer the sandalwood and camphor to the Gopinath deity, because I and Gopinath are not different. This deity was Gopal, but the other deity was Gopinath. He said, we are the same person, so you can offer the sandalwood and camphor.
当这个 Madhavendra Puri 把这些东西带回来之后, 那个 Gopal 神像又出现在他的梦里面说, 你把这个樟脑跟这个檀香呢, 就给这个 Gopinath 神像供奉, 因为我自己跟 Gopinath 是没有分别的。
So in this way, Madhavendra Puri was, you can see how Krishna was reciprocating in his dream, giving him an order of instruction.
所以像Madhavendra Puri这个情况，我们知道呢，Krishna跟他的奉献者甚至在梦里都会交流。Telling
him how he wanted to be saved.
主直接跟他奉献者说，他要怎么样去被服务。So
in Prabhupada's purport, he mentions.
嗯，Prabhupada的要旨说了。It's
a duty in temple worship that one should go to see the deity. Decorated
nicely.
Just like in Hong Kong, everyday people come to see the deity.
就好像香港每天都有人这样去看神像。
Every morning, every evening, you'll see so many different people. They come all the way upstairs, they come into temple. Take off their shoes and then to come and see the deity.
就是说早上啊，晚上啊，每天就是说有很多人啊，进到那边脱下鞋子到神像大厅啊，去见神像。
Just like in India, you see many people. If you go to a city like Jaipur, every morning so many people they come to see Govindaji.
那对，就像这个在印度里那个像 Jaipur 那个庙啊。
Even they're sick, they will come.
即使他们生病,
they won't, because they cannot go through the decay every day, they must see the deity.
因为他们就没办法不去看他,
but Prabhupada said, when they come to temple, the same time, they should have the opportunity to hear the scriptures like Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita. Now we're not only speaking the scriptures for the people who come, we also speak for the pleasure of the deity.
所以我们这样在讲述呢，不是只是给来听的人听，而是也讲给神像听。
Even nobody comes, the deity is here. You can speak for the pleasure of the deity.
即使没有人来，神像还是在这里，所以你可以让神像高兴，跟神像讲话。
Because the deity also can hear.
因为神像是可以听的，会听得到。
Deity likes to hear the scriptures.
那个神像也喜欢听这个经典。
So, but you can see that how difficult it is to maintain a temple.
所以可以知道要去维护这个庙宇是很艰难的。
You bring a deity, and then you don't just only have a deity, you don't just only ring the bell and blow the conch shells.
就真正不是，就只是吹吹海螺、摇摇铃而已。
You have to also have classes regular.
而且要规律的讲课。
Yeah, there has to be so many activities.
必须要很多的活动。
So Lord Chaitanya stressed five different parts of devotional service.
那主持人强调了这个五项的重要的奉爱服务。
Right, there's many different kinds of devotional service, but five are very powerful.
啊，有很多种的奉爱服务，但是有五项是特别有力量。
First of all, kirtan or chanting.
第一个是kirtan或唱诵,
very important.
念诵唱诵非常重要.
We have to all chant the holy name.
我们必须都要去念诵主的圣名.
And then also serving and associating with devotees.
接着是, 服务奉献者跟奉献者联.
We come to the temple to have association.
我们来到庙也是要有联谊的.
And also we come to do service.
而且是来做服务的.
We want to serve the deities.
我们想要服务神像.
We also serve the devotees.
我们也服务奉献者.
We also like to hear.
我们也是喜欢聆听.
Many different speakers are coming to visit Taiwan now.
现在很多不同的讲述者来到台湾。
Many senior devotees coming, giving their association.
很多的资深年长奉献者来给我们联谊。
So devotees should be getting more inspired by hearing from them.
所以奉献者应该觉得, 要从他们那边聆听得到更多的启发。
And when these devotees come, they want to see the deities.
那奉献者来是会想要见神像的。
You come to the temple and say, where's the deities?
所以你到庙里会问说神像在哪里?
They come, we have a darshan, daily darshan.
那就每天的觐见神像。
And of course, this holy place, live in a holy place.
居住在圣地。
The temple is a holy place.
庙是圣地.
Come here. The deity is here. The devotees are here. This is a holy place.
来到庙里，神像在这里，奉献者在这里， 这是圣地.
You can understand all spiritual activities here. There's no sin going on here.
对，我们可以了解，来到这个地方是灵性的地方，没有罪恶的地方.
The devotees carry the Lord in their hearts.
奉献者是把主带在心里的。
And they make this a holy place.
然后把主带在心里, 然后把这个地方变成这个圣地。
So Lord Chaitanya gave great importance to these five activities.
那主Chaitanya非常的, 对这五项强述它的重要。
Said a little attraction for even one of them can give us all perfection.
又说，即使我们对任何一项有一点点吸引的话，也可以让我们得到完美。So
here, Lord Kapila is describing how devotee has no material desire.
在这里，卡比拉描述了一个奉献者是怎么样的没有物质欲望。
Doesn't want to go to the higher planets.
他不会说想要去所谓更高的星球。
He doesn't want mystic yoga powers.
他不想要说什么神力神通啊。
He doesn't even desire to go. You see how the devotees can live joyfully in this life.
所以可以看到奉献者可以在这一世就怎么样的喜乐的过着。
Every day chanting the holy name,
每天念诵着圣名,
seeing the deities,
见到神像,
taking Krishna Prasada,
接受荣耀菩萨的菩萨的.
So when their life is in Krishna consciousness, this life, they have no problem, and the next life also they'll go to be with Krishna.
所以这一世呢, 他们这样做就生活没有问题。 然后下一世呢，就是跟Krishna在一起的生活。
We want to also be like Prabhupada, just to be absorbed in devotional service.
我们就想要跟Prabhupada一样，专注于奉爱服务。
So Lord Kapila is giving some more instruction to his mother here.
那就卡比拉对他的母亲在这里给予更多的训示。
My dear mother, devotees who receive such transcendental opulences are
never.就算是武器啦，武器也好，什么任何岁月的变化啊，都无法去摧毁这样的富裕，因为奉献者把我当做朋友。 把我当做亲戚，也是他们的儿子等等，是他们老师、祝福者，还有也是至尊者，按至尊的。 想他们永远不会被这一些被剥夺所有。
So, Lord Kapila is describing that we have to accept Krishna in one of the rasas. We have to have that relationship with Krishna.
那啊，卡皮拉就说呢，我们必须要有跟 Krishna 任何其中一个关系，这些 rasa。
And when we are properly situated in our relationship with Krishna, then there's no harm can ever come to us.
那如果我们是很恰当的处在这个Krishna 知觉的奉爱里面，就没有任何事情、任何东西可以伤害我们。
In the material world, with the course of time, we lose everything.
当然，在物质世界，随着时间演进，我们所有的一切都会消失，没有。
But not for a devotee.
但对于奉献者来，就不是这样。
Devotee is not under the law of karma.
奉献者就不会是不是在这个业报定律。
The devotee surrendered to Krishna. He's taking shelter of Krishna.
奉献者是向 Krishna 臣服，然后托庇于 Krishna.
You can see Arjuna. Arjuna took Krishna as his friend.
可以见到 Arjuna 把 Krishna 当作朋友。
And because he took Krishna as his friend, so he was always saved in many dangerous situations.
因为他把 Krishna 当作朋友，所以他一直是安全的，在各种危险状况，他都是安全的。
And then Queen Kunti. You can see Uddhava on the far right. Uddhava is also a friend of Krishna at the same time, Uddhava being like a servant of Krishna.
右边的这图片是这乌达瓦，他是在服务着 Krishna 这样子的仆人。
Here you see Balaram also. Balaram also serves Krishna in different rasas.
在Balaram 呢，服务 Krishna 是在不同的 rasa.
And there's a picture of this is Lord Chaitanya showing himself to the devotee, showing the Sadguj form.
右边的呢是主 Chaitanya， 他对他奉献者展示他另外一个形象。
The Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya had a conversation with Lord Chaitanya.
那个Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 跟主 Chaitanya 有个对，有这对话着。
Lord Chaitanya revealed himself to show that he's Krishna and Rama, and he's come now as Lord Chaitanya.
所以呢，主呢就展示出他自己的样子。他同时他自己是Krishna， 也是 Ram， 也是主 Chaitanya。
So Lord Kapila goes on to describe how devotional service simply increases more and more pleasure。
所以卡皮拉就描述的，就是说奉爱服务是怎么样越来越多的增加，而且是越来越多的快乐。
The more we're engaged in devotional service, then we get more and more pleasure from the service. It becomes more and more satisfying.
我们越加的臣服去进行对主的奉爱服务，我们会更越来越多的满足跟快乐。
We get more and more pleasure from Krishna consciousness. The pleasure should be increasing.
我们就会说。在 Krishna 知觉的快乐是越来越多，而且是必然，应该是要越来越多的。
In the material world, the influence of time is to destroy everything. Everything dwindles and dies.
在物质世界，所有的一切都是受到时间的主宰啊，有些停留的、拘留的时间都会结束而毁灭。
But in Krishna consciousness, everything is we see everything is eternal.
那在 Krishna 知觉里面呢，我们最后都是一切都是见到一切都是永恒的灵性的。
There's no time in the spiritual world.
灵性世界是没有时间的影响。
Krishna never grows old.
从来Krishna 永远不会变老。
And with Vaikuntha, everyone is the same age.
所以我们在看到灵性世界, Vaikuntha, 所有的生物都是同样的年龄。
That's the devotee who worships me, the all-pervading Lord of the universe. In unflinching devotional service, gives up all attractions to the spiritual. To the what?
To be promoted,
to be promoted
in the heavenly
planets and to become happy
in this world with both children get to home or anything in relationship with the body. I take him to the other side of birth and death.
So Lord Kapila is describing how the devotee loses all but his no material desire. There's Dhruva Maharaj in this picture. He's gone off to the forest. He's given up all attachments to the world. Initially he wanted a kingdom. But he met Narada Muni, and Narada Muni instructed him in devotional service. So he was practicing bhakti yoga. In the course of time, he became purified. He lost all his material desires. Finally, then the Lord appeared to him. But Dhruva said, I don't want anything. I don't want anything now. So you can see, again, the same thing here. Doesn't matter where I'm born, let me be born even as an ant in the house of a
devotee.这同样又从跟我们在说一句，就不管我们在什么地方出生，甚至愿意在奉献的家里出生为一只蚂蚁都好。And
how? What should the devotees be thinking? We should think ourselves that, you know, I'm such a fallen soul. That let me be born again and again. I just pray that I will not forget your service. We're trying to become devotees. We couldn't have been very, you know, we're still trying to become devotees. We're not very pure.
我们并不纯，并不很纯洁，我们还是在尝试着要成为奉献者。Keep
trying.
我们要必须继续尝试着。
So the material world gives us an opportunity that we can engage in all the things in this world in the service of Krishna.
我们在这物质世界也给我们一个机会，让我们可以来练习进行奉爱服务。
Just like Prabhupada, you can see there. He was a business, he was still trying to preach, trying to give Krishna consciousness. So even the fear of birth and death, all these miseries of the material world, anyone who takes shelter of Krishna, they can be free.
在物质世界是这样，任何人呢，就是脱避于Krishna的话，他可以解脱于这些状态。我们就仅仅是应该要脱避于Krishna。我们必须要了解Krishna是至尊。
Only by taking shelter of Krishna can we get free from the
death.
We need to favor Krishna. So then in the final few verses, Krishna gives some examples how he's the Supreme Lord, how everything is under his power, under his control.
释着说他是怎么样是至尊主，然后呢他的地位状态呢。
The wind blows because of Krishna.
风会吹也是因为 Krishna.
The sun shines out of fear of Krishna.
太阳也是因为怕着 Krishna 而闪烁。
Indra sends rain because he's afraid of Krishna.
这个 Indra 会造雨也是怕着 Krishna.
The fire burns out of fear of Krishna.
火在燃烧也是害怕 Krishna.
So all of these different phenomena in the material world, they're going on under the direction.
所以所有这些现象在进行都是在 Krishna 指示的情况下进行。
Because he is the supreme lord, he's behind everything.
因为 Krishna 是至尊主，他是在所有一切背后的原因。
So the yogis who have this knowledge and who are engaged in devotional service.
所以瑜伽师们呢有这种知识，然后进行奉爱服务。
Then they enter, they go back to God.
那这样子呢，他们就回归守身。
They don't have any problem.
那这样子也没有任何问题。
They have no doubts and no fears.
这样的奉献者是没有疑问，也不会害怕。
So they enter into the kingdom of God.
那他们就进入这个神的王国。
So it's described here how to perform this devotional service.
所以这里描述的就是说怎么样去进行奉爱服务。
Mind has to be fixed on the Lord.
心意必须专注在主。
And we have to practice intensely.
而且要很密切的去练习。
So the best thing to do, first thing, fix the mind on the feet of the Lord.
这个最好的就是首先呢，先把心意专注在至尊主的莲花主。
Service, do service for Krishna.
为 Krishna 做服务。
Krishna consciousness.
那这是 Krishna 知觉。
This is the perfection of human.
那这 Krishna 知觉是人类生命的完美。
This is Lord Kapila's teaching to Jivahuti.
那这是。
Chapter.
这是主卡皮拉对德巴布蒂的教导的部分，在第三篇第二十五章的部分。
Any question?
各位有没有任何问题？
You can see how Lord Kapila is teaching actually devotional services. Nothing different from what we're doing ourselves in Krishna consciousness.
我们可以看到主卡皮拉所教导的奉爱服务跟我们所练习进行的这奉爱服务是没有不同。
But if you study the atheistic Kapila philosophy, then it's simply material philosophy.
但是如果我们去研究这个无神论者卡皮拉的哲学的话，那些只是无神论物质的这些知识。
Nothing about, they don't teach about deity worship, seeing the deities.
那他们的无神论的卡皮拉里面的教导就没有提到什么神像崇拜，也不会见到神像崇拜。
They don't chant the holy name.
他们也不念诵圣名。
They just have some material knowledge of the elements of matter.
那他们那一些呢，只是对物质的元素，只有的知识是物质元素的知识。
They say life comes from matter.
他们是说呢，生命是来自物质。
So the big atheists.
他们就是这样子的物质主义，物质者。
But the Lord Kapila Dev who appeared in Satya Yuga, the son of Devahuti, he is the supreme lord and he is teaching.Devotional service.
而主卡皮拉是德巴库蒂的儿子，但是也是至尊主的本人。那他在教导是这个奉爱服务。
The very important teachings.
这是非常重要的教导。
Lord Kapila giving us a lot of instruction.
主卡皮拉给我们很多的训示。
And Prabhupada lectured on all of the verses in this chapter.
那 Prabhupada 的这个讲课的部分，把所有这些师节都有讲到。
You should read the book, teachings of Lord Kapila.
所以要去读这个书，这个内容，就是 Kapila 的教导。
We don't have it in Chinese, do we?
Long ago.
Lectures.
Yes, separate.
Yeah, and more, yeah. Yeah.